We'll discuss here the graph of the reciprocal function, that is function f of x equal 1 over x. This is one of the basic functions, and therefore to graph it, we construct the table, plot the points, and connect them with a continuous curve. However, before we go to that, let's notice a couple of things about our function. The first, the function is defined only for x's that are non-zero, so the domain of the function is the set of all x's that are not zero. That means that there is no point on the graph that has x-coordinate zero, and that means that the graph of this function will consist of two different parts, one for x's less than zero and one for x's greater than zero. Second, we can easily justify that if x is positive, then y, as the reciprocal, is also positive. And if x is negative, then y is negative. And that means that the graph will be only in the third and the first quadrant. Also, we can quickly show that the function is odd. F of negative x is 1 over negative x, which is negative 1 over x, and this in turn is negative f of x, and therefore f is odd. Now what does that mean for the graph? It means that the graph is symmetric with respect to origin. This also means that to graph this function, it is enough to graph the part for x is greater than 0, and then use symmetry with respect to origin to graph the part for x is less than 0. So let's plot a couple of points for x is greater than 0 only. And let's start with the 1 and 2 and 3. The values of y is 1, 1 half and 1 third. So if I plot those points, here is the point 1, 1. Here will be the point 2 and 1 half. Somewhere here will be point 3 and 1 third. And if I join those points in the order they were plotted, I will just get the part, the little piece. So the question is, what's happening when x's are increasing past the 3, and what's happening to x's between 0 and 1. So let's see what's happening for when x is equal 4, for example. When x is equal 4, the value is going to be 1 fourth. If x is equal 5, the value of y will be 1 fifth. So you can see here, if x is equal 10, the value of y is going to be 1 tenth. If x is equal 100, the value of y is going to be 1/100. So that means that the larger the value of x, the smaller value of y. And that means that those points, if I were to plot, those points are going to come closer and closer to the x-axis. The further I go to the right, the closer to the x-axis my graph is going to be. Now what's happening for x's between 0 and 1? So let's see, if I take 1 half, the reciprocal is going to be 2. If I take 1 third, reciprocal is going to be 3. If I take 1 tenth, reciprocal is going to be 10. So the smaller value of x, the closer to 0 value of x, the higher value of y, and therefore the point is going to come closer and closer to the y-axis. And the graph, if I join those points, has this shape. Now using symmetry with respect to origin, I will get the point negative 1, negative 1, negative 1 half and negative 2, negative 1 third and negative 3, negative 2 and negative 1 half, negative 3 and negative 1 third, and the graph is going to be symmetric with respect to origin, And because of that, when x is closer to 0, the graph is going to approach the y-axis, and when x is large but negative, the graph will approach x-axis. So the graph approaches x-axis and the y-axis, and such lines are called asymptotes. So the x-axis here, the line toward which the graph approaches when x becomes larger and larger, we'll say that x-axis is the horizontal asymptote for this graph. Now, similar property has the line x equals 0, which is the y-axis. The closer axis, the graph approaches this this line when x approaches 0. So the y-axis is also asymptote, but this is a vertical line. Therefore, we'll say that y-axis is a vertical asymptote. This graph has those special properties that not many others have.